That might be possible, let me know.
All right, Madam Clerk, we're going to reconvene the other meeting so that we have enough information to make a decision of the possible course of actions that we can take. So we are moving to resume the meeting from yesterday. And we recessed the meeting on the item 11, which is the second budget amendment or cleanup, as Mr. Mendez called it, and the finance department's.
Right, there were two items, that one and the ratification.
And the ratification of the, yes. Okay, so item 11 is a resolution of the mayor and commission of the city of Sweetwater approving budget revision number 2 of the city operating budget for fiscal year 2014-2015 and amending the city operating budget of the city of Sweetwater. Mayor Lopez and finance director. We don't have the honor to have Mayor Lopez, but we have the honor to have the finance director.
Mr. President?
Yes, sir.
Just to put this in the proper posture, and our finance director has already stated this, but I want to go ahead and put it in the proper context. Under Florida Statute Section 166.241, I believe it's subsection 2, it allows municipalities to go ahead and make amendments to their budget at any time during the fiscal year. However, at the end of the fiscal year, the municipality may only amend their budget 60 days after the ending of that fiscal year. In other words, we basically have until November 30th to make any amendments to the 2014-2015 budget.
Which is very close.
Which is very close. It's for that reason, I would advise you that if you still have issues, questions, comments on this item, I would suggest that you don't adjourn the meeting because you will have little opportunity to go ahead and react to a budget amendment. You may wanna recess if you still have not gotten through analyzing, debating, or considering budget amendment number 2, because frankly you want to make sure that you are, if you are going to have a budget amendment to basically reconcile your numbers for 2014-2015, you can only do so by the 30th. With the caveat that yes, you may come in perhaps Friday and have an emergency meeting for Monday, which is the actual 30th. But I want to make sure you all know the limited time frame that you have to consider and adopt a budget amendment.
Well, I know that the time is of constraint, and I have gone over the budget cleanup. I have some question for Mr. Mendez, and as I expected, and probably all the commissioners expected, there are positions that we never agree on in the budget cleanup. And I spoke to Mr. Mendez, and he told me that even if they were on budgeted positions and the persons were employed and they work, they have to be paid, even if they were unbudgeted. So that constitutes, I think, a huge violation of the Code of Ordinances. But not only that, it constitutes a big load for our already exhausted resources. Y lo voy a decir en español. Estamos evaluando acá la última enmienda que se le hace al presupuesto de la ciudad, lo que se le llama una limpieza final, que donde se reconcilian todos los gastos con todos los ingresos y se mandan a Tallahassee. El tiempo para enviarlo a Tallahassee Es el día 30 de noviembre, se debe de comenzar este budget cleanup el 60 días antes de que finalice el año fiscal. Sabemos lo elaborado que ha sido la tarea del Departamento de Finanzas, pero también sabemos, por pruebas ya lógicas que hemos visto a simple vista y las hemos palpado, que el alcalde ha enfatizado en hacer su voluntad sin contar o guiarse por las ordenanzas de la ciudad o la constitución de la ciudad. Y en esta limpieza final de presupuesto, lo que la comisión le instruyó al alcalde fue que no tuviera estas posiciones que no habían presupuestadas, y vemos aquí todavía las mismas posiciones. Está defendiendo que han habido gastos en la ciudad, que presupuesto, que las taxaciones han sido bajas, pero no pensó en impactar el presupuesto de la ciudad sobre $750,000 trayendo personal nuevo, que ha sido una carga bastante pesada para el presupuesto de la ciudad. Creemos que eso es inaceptable, que es ilegal, y por lo tanto, mi posición como presidente de la comisión, y creo que es la de muchos de mis colegas o de casi todos, es que no se cometan ilegalidades por la administración, como cuerpo legislativo que somos. Así que creo que estas cosas se van a analizar y le vamos a preguntar al abogado de la ciudad si esta noche esas arbitrariedades que se cometieron y que continúan en el presupuesto se pueden enmendar y eliminar y mandarlas para Tallahassee el lunes. Mr. Attorney, can we, because I have gone over this, I don't know the rest of the commissioners.
Yes.
So I don't think that we should postpone this and put it in more time constraint to the finance department and the Director Mendez, and take from this cleanup what have to be taken, or whether it is legal to take it or not. Now, if we remove those unbudgeted positions, what is, because anyway, Mr. Mendez told me today that even if we remove them, the monies are there. The money, they are not going to give the money back to the city. So this constitute a big violation by Mayor Lopez in this particular case as well.
May I, Mr. President? Yes, good evening, Mr. President and Chairman. What I said was that at this point in time, the money is already spent. If the employee was not separated from the city and they continue to work, therefore they got paid, that money was spent. And we balanced the budget accordingly
to those monies.
And we have to show it because we developed the budget cleanup from the system. Excuse me. And a quick history so that you know, I'm trying to make things simple. Again, last fiscal year, we only had two budgets. The number one and this cleanup that is before you tonight. The first budget was adopted.
The adopted budget, right.
On the resolution 4092 on August 26th by the City Commission. Then it was vetoed by the mayor on September 21st. Then it was overridden by the City Commission on the 28th of September. Now, once...
But excuse me, Ricardo.
Yes.
But the mayor continues having those employees on budgeted positions against the instructions of the commission.
Well, that's something that you...
Now, I want to find out, Mr. Attorney, to what extent it is illegal for a director or for even for the city clerk to sign a check or to issue a check or to cut a check against the instructions on the city charter and the court of ordinance because just the mayor told them to do so.
Can I just quickly finish?
Go ahead.
My thought. Okay, once that override took place by the city commission, this became the official document, and therefore this what we input into the city's financial system. And then when it comes time to do the budget cleanup, which is before you tonight, those are the numbers that we use, the numbers in the system.
I understand that, Ricardo. I am not blaming you for that. But what is questionable right now, because we know an employee here, a director that left the city because she was not probably happy with what she was asked for. And at this very moment, I want to ask the city attorney if a director have to fulfill orders or to complete orders from the mayor, or have to respect the city charter and the code of ordinances. What is the course of action here now? And I know that it's a delicate issue because nobody wants to be fired. But by the same token, or you are fired, or you just violate the constitution of the city, which is the city charter and the code of ordinances. You cannot issue a check for a person that is not approving the budget by the commission. That's my understanding. And I don't know, I am not an attorney. I want to find out what is your legal opinion on this.
Mr. President, I'm going to give you a two-part answer. The first part of my answer basically takes me to the same section of the Florida statutes that create this deadline of 60 days after the end of the fiscal year for this commission to adopt a budget any budget amendment. Section 166.241, subsection 2, in relevant part provides that the adopted budget must regulate expenditures of the municipality. And an officer of a municipal government may not expend or contract for expenditures in any fiscal year except pursuant to the adopted budget. Okay? Having said that, to the extent that within this budget amendment you have expenditures that were obviously not incorporated in the adopted budget, your approval of that amended budget
makes it valid.
Let me add the following. At the same time, it approves whatever excess revenue may be provided therein. So the budget amendment, as I imagine, contains both additional revenues and additional expenditures, and that's how you are reconciling your 2014-2015 fiscal year. I think that the dates are important. The override took place 3 days before the end of the fiscal year. I believe it was September 28th. Mr. Mendez?
Yes.
September 28th. So the override took place 3 days before the end of the year. Now, those individuals, correct me if I'm wrong, those individuals were in city employment. I know that those are the positions that this commission has been basically directing the mayor to eliminate if they were not properly funded within last year's budget. At this point, those monies were spent. And if you don't approve that, if you don't approve those, I will defer to Mr. Mendez for a moment, but then we may have an unbalanced end of year amendment unless other adjustments are made. And that's why what I wanted to tell you, that you have to look at this not only in light of the unbudgeted positions. This commission may decide that whatever funding was provided in those positions, that hey, that you deem that to be an unauthorized payment. Okay? But at the end of the day, you still need to balance the budget.
I understand.
You still need to provide a balanced end of year budget amendment. So can you amend this? Absolutely. You can amend it any way you wish.
We have amended on
the chair.
Go ahead, Commissioner Bergen.
Okay, it's two things. First of all, forget about all those dates that he gave. Mm-hmm. None of those positions were budgeted at any time during and including up to that last revision that he talked about.
No, I understand. That's what that's
been overridden and everything. They were never in there.
It would mean that you basically are not authorizing that expenditure.
Okay. Now, can we have it so that we can approve the budget amendment? And I don't know how you would do this legally.
Absolutely.
Have an asterisk, a note, or something. But we're approving the budget as to follow the law, file on time, keep the books balanced, but at no time are we authorizing.
You're making it legitimate if you approve it.
But I'm asking if we can make it so that we say, listen, we spent the money, it's gone. The money's there. I mean, it's gone. We're not going to get it back. We spent it. So we're writing it in the book so it's all applicable and all the books are balanced. But at the same time, can we make some kind of a legal amendment to that saying, listen, but at no time are we authorizing the illegal payments. We're just doing what we have to do financially. Is it possible or no?
That's not what I know.
Approving this end of year amendment as is basically gives the commission's approval to everything that is included in it. I don't think you can apply caveats to that. If
we don't approve it, we stay with the other one that was balanced anyway, the one that was before that.
I would defer to the finance director as to the impact of staying only with
the revenues are not going to match the expenditures at the end of the year.
This is like this action that is before you tonight is to comply with auditing standards and even state law. And that's like the city attorney said, we have 60 days from the end of the fiscal year. And that's why we work really hard to bring you this budget cleanup. It has no financial impact. The money has already spent. And therefore, we respectfully request that we can move
forward. We understand your point, but you have to understand the legality of this. If we approve this budget cleanup, we are making legitimate all what is in that budget, and there are a lot of things that are not legitimate and are not legal.
I understand fully, and in light of that, I'm going to say two things clearly, okay? There are two issues here. Number one, there are things where the elected officials need to come together. And number two, there are decisions that are outside of the realm of the finance department. Decisions that we cannot make, that we do not have the authority to make. Thank you.
So, Mr. Attorney, according to what I see here, we know that there are employer positions being paid here, that we cannot ask those employees to give the money back to the city. Neither probably we can legally ask the mayor to pay the city back those monies. Probably that's not the case. So what is the provision of the Florida statute if we don't comply with this document at the end of the year?
Good question.
You don't have to pass this budget amendment, but you do need to reconcile your book, so to speak. And the vehicle is a budget amendment. It doesn't have to be this one, okay?
To comply with
auditing standards.
Okay,
that is what creates the need for this budget amendment so that you can have a balanced end of the year amendment. Throughout the budget process, you have your you know, you adopt, you have a final adopted budget, which is your operating budget. At any time throughout the year, you may make amendments to it. But to make the final amendment where you're going to go ahead and just reconcile your fiscal year, you have to do it 60 days after. If you don't do it, for example, in this particular scenario, if you do not approve a end of budget amendment, end of year budget amendment, you may not be in compliance with auditing standards. That's what happens. You may not be in compliance.
Well, the mayor is not in compliance.
When I say you, I mean the city as a whole.
Okay, the administration is not complying because they didn't take the instruction from the commission not to have those positions pay because they were unbudgeted and they were brought, you know, to cover or to do something that he didn't bring to the commission before. And that's because the Mayor Lopez said that we don't work with him. No, he does whatever he wants, and then he comes to the commission. Mm-hmm. And that's not the way it goes. So, go ahead, Commissioner Bergen.
With what Mr. Aguada said at the beginning of the meeting, I think it's going to be the most logical thing, because at the end of the day, that's what we're elected for, to be responsible, even though others are not. So I believe that if we find the time, the short time that we have, to try to find out more legalities of a way that maybe we can solve this problem instead of just doing it in haste, and we'll come back on Monday and have a meeting 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, before they have the deadline at 5 o'clock, we might have a better answer legally to solve the problem. Because at the bottom line, forget the politics, we want to solve this problem. Because it's just going to turn into a bigger problem with a budget for 15-16 if the numbers don't match. And that whole night.
Well,
the state
he's got someone has to pay for their mistakes. So we have been covering the city, protecting the city from expenditures, because we don't want to send to court the mayor, because that's going to incur in expenditures from the city funds. And now we are going to send this to Tallahassee. We are going to make it legitimate that all what he did was proper and correct.
I'm not saying to do that.
I don't really, you know what? Let Tallahassee take care of the mayor if we cannot take care of him. That's my bottom line. But it is up to the commission. He has violated time, month after month, time after time. I know that this should be in compliance with the Florida statute. Let the mayor pay the consequences of not complying with this, because he didn't follow the instruction of this commission on not to fund these unbudgeted positions. Y lo voy a decir en español a nuestra comunidad también. Estamos en una discusión con relación a esta enmienda final que se le hace a presupuesto del año 2014-2015 con relación a reconciliar todas las entradas de dinero y todos los gastos de dinero. Mes tras mes le hemos instruido al alcalde López que habían ciertas posiciones que él trajo que no estaban presupuestadas, que no podían estar siendo un peso para el presupuesto de la ciudad. El alcalde se ha reído de esto y tiempo tras tiempo ha continuado haciendo lo mismo. Ahora esto hay que mandarlo el 30 de noviembre a Tallahassee. Si nosotros aprobamos esto, estamos haciendo legítimo todas las decisiones arbitrarias que el alcalde ha tomado hasta el día de hoy. ¿Y saben qué? Yo por lo menos estoy cansado ya de tratar de mantenerme tranquilo, de no tomar medidas que vayan a dañar a la ciudad. Pero a este señor no le importa la ciudad y va a continuar haciendo lo mismo, porque si nosotros hacemos este documento legítimo, él va a seguir diciendo que vamos a tener que haciendo lo mismo por todos los 4 años que tenga que estar en el poder. Y nosotros no, digo yo por lo menos no estoy de acuerdo con esto. Yo revisé ese presupuesto, lo comparé a que nosotros le hicimos los amendments y fuimos en contra del veto que le hizo el alcalde. Y ahí están las mismas posiciones presupuestadas que fueron traídas ilegalmente por el alcalde. Si aprobamos esto, mi convicción es, y como lo dijo el city attorney, el abogado de la ciudad, vamos, de hecho, aunque no estemos de acuerdo, vamos a hacer legítimo este documento. Si no está bajo la ley, que venga el Estado y que le diga al alcalde qué es lo que tiene que hacer para que pueda funcionar como debe funcionar un alcalde, donde hay leyes y hay regulaciones que hay que seguir para dirigir una ciudad.
Mr. President, I just want to make sure that I get to fully answer the question you asked earlier as to what are the repercussions of not having an end of year budget amendment that basically closes out the books. And I believe that the finance director can go ahead and expand on that. But basically, you may have a finding in your final audit. There's potential for that. There's also potential for perhaps a fine from the state.
Mr. Attorney, but let me tell you this. Year after year, since I've been a commissioner here, there were 16, 15, 14 findings in any budget. It was a time in which we didn't have this report for 3 years consecutive. Uh-huh. And we are still here alive.
Mr. President,
I'm not a messenger.
I
understand, sir.
In no way, shape, or form, I am advocating for one position or another one. You asked a very direct question, and I want to give you a very direct answer. What are the what can happen? Finding in the audit, and perhaps a fine from the state.
Maybe we need some findings.
And I believe that that's what may occur, unless Mr. Mendez has anything else to add.
Definitely. Again, we don't want any more findings. Okay, from a practical standpoint, we want to properly close our books. Okay, we want to comply with the state law, and we want to move forward. And the fact that it happened in the past doesn't necessarily mean that it needs to that we need to keep getting findings. We don't want any more of that. From a practical standpoint, the money has already been paid. The people worked for the city. We had to pay them. And we developed the budget cleanup from the system. And we input the system from the budget that was approved by the commission when the override took place.
So, that's wrong. You're saying something that's wrong. Show me where you imported the unbudgeted positions.
Well, as I was explaining to the city attorney and Mr. President, again, This fiscal year only had two budgets. The first
Come on, man. You're going in circles.
Okay. Well,
no spinning. No spinning.
Let me tell you that the minute on September 28th that the override took place, this became the official document. And therefore, these were the numbers that we input in the system.
Okay.
And but we developed the cleanup from the system.
That's fine. But those numbers do not include the unbudgeted positions.
Well,
so you put in the budget
violation.
The mayor paid it,
again.
And you signed the check
again.
With the ordinance that I gave you. Say
again,
you can't do
it. There are decisions that are outside of the finance department, and therefore there are issues which the elected officials have to agree upon, so that we can move forward.
We have agreed. The one that doesn't agree is you.
No.
Yeah, you agree just to do what the mayor says.
We worked really hard.
Right.
We worked really hard to put this budget together and bring it before you.
May I?
Go ahead, Commissioner.
Man, this is impossible. You may want to, Mayor say to you, you're right. You're not right. You understand everybody see why? You're beautiful, man. But this is impossible. It's impossible. Who right? Two, no one. You don't respect the commission. You never say to the mayor, no, the commission passed this. Why?
Again, Commissioner Duasso.
I'm sorry.
I understand, and with all due respect, just like I said a minute ago,
there are decisions that are outside of the realm of the finance department that we do not have authority to make.
I don't understand that question. I don't understand. Commissioner say this employee's eye. Why you make check? These people not working for the city. Commission say no.
We don't.
Why you make check? This money you pay later.
We don't have the authority to make.
Right.
We don't have the authority to make those changes.
Mr. President,
I would like
to have findings in the financial statement for the city. And my vote is no in this budget revision. I'm not going to prove this tonight. Okay. Is Mr. Attorney, is any penalty if we don't approve this tonight? What's going to be the next step? Because, like I said, I not agree with the budget revision because
they can ask for an extension to record this,
right?
Because it has happened in the past,
mm-hmm,
for 3 years, and then they should put in here what we voted for.
The relative to the findings in the audit, those can be discussed with the auditor, and basically, if everything is put into context as to why administration is bringing this end of year budget amendment number 2, and why this commission is, you know, feels that they cannot adopt it, all those arguments may come into the audit, and perhaps the issue may work itself out and not result in a finding. It may result in a finding. Relative to the state, same thing. If those arguments are made that would perhaps preclude the state from issuing a fine, that may happen, or the state may issue a fine for us not complying.
You cannot request an extension to the state?
You have 60 days. In other words, you don't have to send anything necessarily to Tallahassee. Simply, if you're going to go ahead and make a budget amendment,
mm-hmm,
after the end of the fiscal year, you have to make that. You have to approve the budget amendment anytime within those 60 days. You have 60 days. In other words, if you need to make a budget amendment, you just have to do it within those 60 days. I don't have an answer for you relative to the extension. I can go ahead and get together with the finance director tomorrow morning and find out whether we can. If in fact we can, you know, this commission can issue a directive to perhaps request it. Absolutely.
Okay.
But I don't know at this point, but I can find out.
You don't understand, but I prefer you to find if we have an extension, because I don't know what's going to be happening to the next.
Okay,
meeting.
Commissioner. For the records, Commissioner Maroño is she has to go to take care of her father.
Thank you.
Okay.
Take a motion and get it over.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, I need a motion for item 11.
I make a motion to disapprove the...
The budget cleanup.
The budget cleanup.
And
second.
I second it.
To disapprove.
Okay,
to
there
disapprove.
Is a motion by Commissioner Breguignan not to approve the budget cleanup under these circumstances of being violated by the Mayor Lopez, having unbudgeted positions being paid during all this time.
Okay, now
Mr. President?
Yes.
Just to clarify that since the motion is in the negative, uh-huh, to disapprove the resolution, if you do not want the budget revision, the vote would be yes. If you want the budget revision, or if you don't agree with that motion, then your vote is no. But if you don't want the budget revision, your vote is no. I'm sorry, your vote is yes.
Well, it depends how we stated the motion.
No,
the
motion.
To disapprove.
To disapprove.
Okay.
So if we are agreeing with the disapprove,
you have to say
if
yes.
If you agree
yes
with the motion,
yes,
you vote yes.
Yes.
Okay, fine.
Okay. So there is a motion by Commissioner Breguignan and second by Commissioner Barreto and myself to disapprove the budget amendment number 2, or the so-called budget cleanup. Roll call, Madam Clerk.
Commissioner Suarez?
Yes.
Commissioner Duwalsa?
Yes.
Commissioner Bergignon?
Yes.
Commissioner Barreto?
Yes.
Commissioner Yano?
Yes.
President Diaz?
Yes. Item 11 have passed unanimously, disapproving the budget cleanup because the reason that we have been discussing for a while. This budget cleanup includes on budgeted positions that Mayor Lopez, violating the Code of Ordinance, didn't take the instructions of this commission not to pay them. Esta revisión de presupuesto número 2 no ha sido aprobada por esta comisión, basado en que aquí hay posiciones que no han sido presupuestadas y que en total
y otra directiva
ignorancia del alcalde López las mantuvo acá, poniendo un peso enorme en el presupuesto de la ciudad por más de $750,000.
Y otra cosa que nosotros hemos mandado hacer, que no se cumplieron aquí.
Exactamente. Muchas cosas más. Además de esas posiciones no presupuestadas, muchas cosas más que nosotros como comisión instruimos que creemos que es para el bienestar de esta ciudad y que el señor López ha ignorado constantemente.
President of the Commission.
Go ahead, Commissioner Yang.
Okay. Are we going to be adding these violations to the ones that we're going to take consideration to take it to court?
That is up to you when we open the discussion for this item. Okay, so let's move to item number 12, ratification of department heads, core requirement. Again, here we have ratification after 5 months of the director of the chief of police for the city of Sweetwater. Mayor Lopez don't have any other name to the United States that the interim chief Plácido Díaz. Queremos reiterar en español que esta es ya, no sé por cuántas veces, traemos a la comisión a una reunión, ya sea especial como regular, la ratificación del jefe de la policía, y aparentemente no existe otra opción en los Estados Unidos de Norteamérica que el señor que tiene el alcalde López, que es el señor Plácido Díaz, que no fue ratificado y que por ordenanza el señor alcalde debía haber traído otro nombre, es decir, otra persona, a presentárselo a esta comisión. Así que estamos, verdaderamente quisiéramos que estas cosas no ocurriesen, pero no tenemos otra alternativa. No tenemos alcalde, no tenemos jefe de policía, no tenemos chief of staff, tenemos un jefe de departamento de finanzas que ha tenido que enfrentar cosas muy inciertas.
Tiene que obedecer.
Pero tenemos que seguir adelante.
Mr. President.
Through the chair.
Commissioner Barreto. Go ahead.
Thank you.
I'll give you the floor right after.
I had a question for Mr. Attorney. For how long the mayor could have interim chief of police?
Well, the requirement is that when there is a name brought to this commission for ratification as chief of police, if that person is not ratified, at the next meeting, the next immediate meeting, whether it is a special meeting or whether it is a regular meeting, another name needs to be submitted to the commission for consideration. There are other provisions in the code that relate to different circumstances dealing with the vacancy of that particular of a department head position, where it puts a limit of 45 days for purposes of
trying to have people apply.
But for purposes department heads coming here for ratification, basically it's the next meeting. The next immediate meeting, whether special or regular, a new name needs to be submitted. And at that point,
it's Barreto Diaz.
you either ratify it or don't ratify it, and that continues until you actually ratify somebody.
But the problem is this, Commissioner Barreto, and I think that, correct me if I am wrong, our city charter have to be amended from scratch.
Yep.
Because there are violations, but you don't have how to enforce or punish that violation. And that's what this is the case that we have. Commissioner Suarez.
Yes, I'd like to ask a question. What's the current situation on the park director? Do we have one? Do we need one?
I'm sorry, Commissioner Suarez.
What's the current situation on the park director? Do we have one? Do we need one? Is there an interim?
I'm
sorry, that question is for administration. I don't have the specific any specific answer for that.
We don't have anybody from the administration here.
No.
Not even the finance director. You have an answer for that, Mr. Mendez? Do we have a park director?
No, we don't have one.
I don't know if it was
Mayor Lopez has stated that because of the financial constriction, that position this year was going to be vacant, and then that his personal people over there are taking care of business.
We could not afford one right now. So one of the strategies was to consolidate city assets, share city assets, consolidate services. And in the meantime, while we overcome our cash flow and our financial challenge, we are, I believe that our leadership is addressing the parks director position through some other city employees at this point.
That was a good decision.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so do I have a motion?
You may adjourn this
meeting, yes. Do I have a motion to adjourn this meeting?
Move.
That is a motion second. By Commissioner Barreto, second by Commissioner Suarez Sanduazo. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Meeting is being adjourned at 9:56 p.m. And now we're going to proceed.
Mr. President, could we have just a couple of
minutes?
Yes, of recess before we reconvene on
okay.
tonight's meeting.
All right. Okay.
Yeah, we're adjourned, so.
Yeah. Yeah, 5 minutes, I need to go.